The time has come, my vaping friends. My most anticipated mod of 2015 is here, the Yeehee SX Mini M-Class. Stay tuned. Hey everybody, and welcome back to this edition of the Vapor Chronicles. Tonight is going to be an exciting show. I have sent to me for free for the purpose of this review the Yeehee SX Mini M-Class with the Yeehee SX350J chip, which is the new temperature controlled chip. What you have here is a regulated mod that has an original chip that is from China that is in the upper realm of price. You're looking at about $199. And this mod was sent to me for free for the purpose of this review from wetvapes.com. The price is around $199 for this mod. And, wetvapes is fast shipping, great reliable customer service, and an excellent experience for you if you're looking to buy everything from, you know, mods to juice to tanks. They have everything there. Check out their site, and if there's anything you're interested in, you can pick it up from Wet Vapes. I am a vape enthusiast. I am a former smoker that found freedom from smoking from vaping, and that is all. I'm not an engineer, and I don't claim to be. I don't have degrees that, you know, make me the most reliable source for technical information. But what I do provide is, I think, a great perspective, because truthfully, mods and vaping can be a little bit overwhelming for 99.9% of all of us out there that just want to basically just not smoke and have a good quality vape that doesn't dry hit and taste like shit. That's where I come in. I'm going to help guide you, hopefully, and give you my impressions, my perspectives, and be truthful and honest about my experience with devices. And this device in particular, it's not a simple device. So if you're new, this is not going to be a device that I would recommend being your first introduction to the world of vaping. It's complicated. It is actually so complicated that there are things that I nor other vape reviewers don't even understand. And I'm not going to claim to, because I don't want to get ripped in the comments by somebody that has more education and more experience with this kind of stuff than I do. I'm just one man, and I'm going to give my experience with it. Now, with that said, I do have experience with temperature control. I have a Authentic Vapor Shark DNA, Authentic Vapor Flask DNA 40 that I've been using. I've done a lot of nickel builds. I have a Vapor Shark DNA 40 here that I've used. I have some clones that I've used that have temperature control. I have a Heat Vape Mini that I've used. So my experience is pretty good, and I know there have been many things in the past that I haven't liked about temperature control. My favorite mod that I've ever owned was the Yeehee SX Mini. It was the most reliable, and truly that chip was wonderful, and it performed exceptionally well, and I swear by it. It was worth every penny that I spent buying it, and I've been using it ever since I got it. When something new comes out like the Yeehee SX Mini M-Class with a new chip, a redesigned outer shell, everything's new, it's going to take a while to do this review the best that I possibly can. So you're going to see some cuts, you're going to see some edits. I'm filming this in steps throughout the day, and I'm going to try to be as thorough as possible and also not bore you at the same time. But I will get a little bit technical. Hopefully on the vape team later on in the month, we'll have David back, because he's going to be a regular on the show once a month, or maybe even more, we'll see, to shed his experience once he gets his device. I know Mike Vapes has his device. BK, you know, we have power in numbers and experience, and we all help each other. And with new technology, we need it. You guys need it, that are going to spend your hard-earned money to get the devices. So I'm going to try to do my best to start here, but this will not be the end of my review of the SX Mini M-Class. This is just my initial impressions, my initial run-through on the device, things I found out, things I like, things I don't like. But this is not the end-all, be-all. Watch other reviews, watch the vape team, and then make your own choice whether to buy or not to buy. All right. So let's do this. Let's skip all this. Let's jump in, dive down, and I'll see you in a sec. All right, guys. So this is how everything came shipped and packaged from Wet Vapes. And let's do this. Let's open it up. Oh, it also came in this little SX Mini tote bag. which was kind of neat. Alright, so in the box you have your instruction and your warranty card. I recommend reading your instruction brochure and manual. Micro USB charging cable. That's it. Alright guys, let's take a minute and let's run down some lists of features and specifications of the device. So the device has a Yeehee Cigar SX350J processor. It does feature temperature control. It has a dual mode, which is 10J to 50J, which is 200 to 580 degrees Fahrenheit or 100 to 300 degrees centigrade. It has a maximum of 120 watts, which is a little misleading because that is with a tube extender that makes it look ridiculous. So your standard wattage is going to be 60 watts unless you go into the direct mode, which would be the non-regulated mode. I think that's 80 watts if I'm not mistaken. 85 watts in bypass mode. Single battery, 60 watts regulated. It has an output voltage of 1 to 9.5 volts. It has a resistance of 0.08 ohms to 3 ohms. It has buck boost and boost DC to DC converter. Three modes, powerful, standard, soft, and that's not actually true. It has four modes. It also has a powerful plus. It charges via USB. Stainless steel and high quality aluminum body, ergonomic design. It does have a gravity sensor that's built in, upgradable software capability, graphic user interface, reverse polarity, output short, low resistance, low battery voltage, and overheat protection, all included with the device. In your kit, you'll get the SX Mini device, USB cable, user manual, warranty card, and gift box and bag. So that is it. There are the specs. Let's continue with our review. So let's compare this naturally to the original Yeehee SX Mini that I have here. So right off the bat, I noticed that this one is slightly higher, a tiny bit, the new one, tiny bit. And maybe that's, no, it's flush. Tiny bit. I'll show you. Tiny. Looks like they have these channels here. There's four now, but they don't go to the edge. This one had two. Spring-loaded 510. Same on the other. Right off the bat, what you'll notice is all the edges are rounded on the new version. The old version had a lot of sharp edges, and even like on the base right here at the 510, this is a little beveled here at the edge. No sharp corners, no sharp turns. Also on the firing button, the old one had, let's see. Hard to convey that here, but this one is more smooth and rounded, so you're not going to catch your finger. This one was sharp on the edge here, right there, and the other one, this one is more rounded and smooth, so you're not going to catch anything. Same thing at the bottom of the device, the corners. You can see on the new one it's rounded more, so you don't have any sharp edges like you had on this one that were really sharp. But I mean, aesthetically it's very similar. The paint has a more of a high gloss on the new version. But they almost look identical if you didn't know what you were looking for. From the bottom, it looks like there's some markings on here. The only place it really says M-Class is right here at the bottom. And it says SX350J, and this had the SX350. It's still the same battery door, which we'll talk about in a minute, and I'll gripe a little bit. I wish it said M-Class maybe here. That would be kind of cool. But from the side, it appears there's a little bit more of a curvature in the body. See that little breath right here, that little indent? That's a little bit more curvature to get a grip and have a little bit more of a contour on the device. And this is kind of beat up. I mean, the paint's chipped and everything like that. This paint feels very similar to this paint here. I hope it doesn't chip like this one did, because I used to get some chips, but you know, you use a mod, you damage a mod. That's just the way it works. I do notice that on the new version, notice how here, this is smooth right here. And then this one has that little lump, that little bump right there. So it has a more of a contour here, but at the top, this one was much more aggressive at the top, which I kind of like the old version better for that. It felt more like holding a gun or a pistol and your hand would rest up against it. This one still has it, but it's just less aggressive. But the indent here, though, is let your sort of right here on your palm rest in there a little bit more naturally for firing. So, you know, it's a trade-off. I'm sure there's a reason for that. You know, maybe they wanted to have it more. I don't know. I don't know the reason for that, but you can see the difference here. See? Maybe they wanted it to be a little more smooth. This was too jagged because it has a little bit of a sharpness here, so they rolled it off. But either way, minor improvements, minor enhancements. That's pretty much the extent of the outside of the mod. Smoothing it off, rounding it off, better fit and finish. And that's the way it is. So getting into the battery compartment. You can charge here with the micro USB, but if you wanted to get in the battery compartment, you can do one of two things. I griped on my original SX review because I hated getting in here. What I found from other people is if you just take the base of your thumb and just push on here, you can actually undo this with your thumb. Real simple. I usually put it on my finger here and I just spin the mod or just spin it on my hand like this, and that works. You can also grab a coin and put a coin in here and just spin it that way. So whichever floats your boat, whatever you like, you do that. Not a problem. So there's your battery. I have a Samsung, which I love, these INR 18650 25Rs. And here's the inside of the device. It's beautiful, nice threading, great conductivity. So I love it. And when you put this in here, and before you turn it on or before you close it, hold the fire button. This is a little trick. And start to tighten. I'm gonna use this, so I'm gonna use one hand. So hold the fire button, start to turn. And it'll tell you the version number of the firmware. So this is a version 1.4 of your firmware. Pretty neat little trick. All Yihe chips do that. So there you go. That's my firmware for anyone that's interested. Once this is in, once your battery is in, you want to just tighten it down. Not all the way, but you want to make sure it's flush and secure. And to turn the device on, you do 5 clicks. And let's zoom in here. To turn your device on, you want to hit it 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you don't have a tank on, it'll say check atomizer. But you basically have all of your readouts here. You have your battery voltage, you have your ohm resistance, you have your temperature if you're in temperature mode, you have the setting for how the power ramps up when you fire the fire button, you have your joule reading at the bottom, and then you have your wattage or joule reading over here on the top side here. Okay, you can adjust your settings for how it fires. Now let me explain this. If you've never experienced it, you're gonna have to try it yourself to really feel what it feels like, but it's really, really cool. When you press a button on any regulated vaporizer, how quickly the power accelerates and how quickly it meets its target changes the feeling of the vapor you're vaping. On standard mode, the power goes up to its prescribed setting and then it stays there the whole entire time. if you were to adjust it to powerful, it actually overshoots the target to heat up the coil if you have like a real thick camfo build, or if you're dripping and you have a real low resistance, it heats it up quicker and then it levels out and stays where at your target. They have a new setting in here called Powerful Plus, and Powerful Plus ramps it up even more than before, and it's really, really cool how that works. They also have the Soft, which, you know, it builds up the power more slowly and then it levels out, and then your Standard, which is like every other device on the market. Really cool feature. It works in temperature mode. It also works in standard mode. Now, let's go back to the menu. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and there you go. Now, one of the great advancements in this model over the previous is the ability to adjust your settings with the buttons. Now, I don't personally mind the the gravity sensing, which you can actually do by holding it like this sideways, and then you can tilt. It's hard to do with this angle, but you can tilt, and you can tilt, and then when you want to lock it in, you just hit the fire button, and then it locks it in. But I like this easier because it's sideways. So to toggle through all your settings, you just hit the fire button, and you have exit, you have system on and off, you have link on and off, which would be for upgrading the firmware. You also have display left, which flips it, or you could have it display right, or you could have it auto, which I prefer. You also have your power and joule, and you can see that if I tilt it, it flips automatically. So as I go this way, it flips it, and if I go this way, it flips it. This is your standard mode, which is power. That would be your wattage adjustment, and then you have your joule mode, which is your temperature control. So you set that. Let's set it for power. You have all the way up to 60 watts. If you hold the button down, it'll scroll all the way down to the bottom until you hit the very bottom. I'm not going to waste your time because I did this in my original SX video. And then you just click it, and that's what it is. Now, you also have your bypass on or off, and your bypass would be bypassing regulated the regulation of the device and using strictly whatever your battery settings are for the tank that you have on there, similar to a mechanical mod. So you can turn off your system, but that's pretty much it. Now, to set your temperature, you do that in here. Once you go to joules mode, click it. You set your joules, click it, and then it'll ask you what you want your temperature to be. So say we set it for 420 degrees, click it again. It'll ask you if you want it in Fahrenheit or Celsius. We're gonna keep it in Fahrenheit, and then you can exit the screen by clicking the center. You can exit the screen by clicking left, and then you go back to your main. So there you have it. That's like a standard mod up to 60 watts. And to lock your device, hit it three times, and it's locked. Hit it three times again, unlocks. And to power down here, and then go to system on, you go to system off, and it says bye-bye, and it shuts off. So that's pretty much it. It's like the original with some upgrades. And I really, really like the way that the buttons feel. They're nice and clicky, responsive, and they feel good in the fingers. If I could make any recommendation for a future revision of this chip, it would be, since most of us hold our mods in our hands when we're making adjustments, it would have been nice if we, let's zoom out. Would have been nice if when we went into the main menu, or even in the regular menu, instead of it just flipping this way and then flipping this way, which it's not doing. Yeah, there you go. It would have been nice if you went vertical and it actually showed the readings vertically so you could read it up and down. Also in the menu, it would have been nice to have all of the readings up and down so you could tilt this way and this way, a little bit more natural, to the eyes, instead of having to turn your head sideways to read everything sideways. All right, little complaint, but you know, nothing's perfect, so I got to talk about what I don't like about a device. I also would like if they would have had a little bit more texture on here, so if I needed to use my fingernails to get a grip of this, because sometimes it's hard to get the pressure here, a little bit more texture or something here so I can work it a little bit easier, that would have been a big help. Maybe even come up with an innovative new magnetic button at the bottom or something that you can just push it and it clicks out and then you can just remove it, or a hinge would be cool with like a magnet. I don't know, think about it, innovate. This is kind of old in my opinion, but whatever, it's stable, it works, but they can always have improvements. But that's it. So you see the outside of everything, you saw the menu system, you saw the design upgrades. I really, really dig what they've done. I do wish it said M-Class on the side to differentiate it from the original, instead of just having that little M on the bottom. But hey, I like badges and displays of upgrades, you know? Okay, so what I've been doing is I have a twisted nickel and canthal build that has worked really, really good for temperature control so far in all my devices. That was on the Vape Team. Watch episode 3, and David talks about it. It's been wonderful, and you know, I can't say anything bad about it. It's easier to build. It works well. You basically take your 28-gauge canthal, 28-gauge nickel. There's even a special nickel that he recommends that I'm going to order and pick up soon. But even with my regular nickel, regular canthal, it's performed great. It's been reliable, consistent, and easier to build with the twisted. I have this Limo or Lemo 2 right now almost empty. I mean, there's a little tiny bit of juice in here. And I've been doing this on purpose. Okay, I have this set to 40 joules, which is basically, I think, about 40 watts if I'm understanding this whole joules thing correctly. It's reading 0.14 ohms, and it's set to 460 degrees Fahrenheit. And the tank is almost empty, so I want to see what happens as I finish this tank until it dries out and see if I get any dry hits, even at 460 degrees Fahrenheit. So let's find out. And I'm going to fast forward some of this as I'm puffing away here, having a cup of coffee. So bear with me if I fast forward. I just don't want to have this video be, you know, an hour and a half long. I also have the power setting to powerful, which I found that I like for heating up the twisted build. What I'm noticing is that the hit is still producing vapor. It's just getting less and less as time goes on. Even at 460 degrees, I'm not dry hitting. And that is exactly what I want out of temperature control. So I can vape a tank, not look down at it, and or I can tilt my tank and it's not going to dry hit. Now I'm getting the error, dry coil, no liquid. I'm damn impressed with that. That is so good. I mean, I can tell you with my Vapor Sharks, with having trouble screwing it on, and I know they've updated it, but that's another negative of the DNA 40. Number one, DNA 40 doesn't have enough power. 40 watts is not enough power. This has 60 watts. Big seller. Number two, my version, which was updated a week later, and they don't have firmware updates, which also sucks. I can't even update it to the new firmware, so I have to screw on my Addy, and I have to check the settings, it doesn't respond or know that it's a new Addy, and then I have to do it again and again and again, and it's just frustrating. This thing, click the two buttons when your Addy's at room temperature, it reads the settings, it's accurate, and then I set the Fahrenheit for my preferences, I set the joules, which is basically similar to wattage, for my preferences, and then I vape away, even at 460 degrees Fahrenheit. It produces a billowing, flavorful vape as the tank drains. And as soon as it continues to drain, the vape gets less and less, but it's still flavorful. And then it dries out, doesn't dry hit once, even at 460, which is my preference. It's awesome. That is what they nailed. They nailed it. Whether it's, you know, I was reading comments and they were saying it clones the DNA chip. They clone this, they clone that. They might have used Inspiration, but I can tell you this, this thing vapes a hell of a lot better than my $280 DNA 40. It just does. You might have different experiences than me, but I'm just here. This is my channel. I'm sharing my experience, and that's what it is. And I have no affiliation with Yeehee whatsoever. I'm not a fanboy. I don't care where they're from on the planet Earth, because we're all Earthlings. You know, I just like to vape. I like a good vape. I'm not a high-end guy. I'll vape clones. I vape middle of the road, you know, but my experience with the SX Mini and now the SX Mini M Class is that it's money well spent. If you have it in your budget, and I know some of you don't, if you do have it in your budget, it's well worth the investment. If you're into rebuilding, if you're into nickel, or if you just want a great, powerful, you know, quality feeling, awesome performing chip, even if you don't do nickel, it's a great device. And it's, I think, like 10 bucks more than the original SX Mini, which they're not even producing anymore. So that's it. We're going to cut now because I'm going to go to something else on this long review. So hang in there, guys. Grab some coffee, press pause, and have a vape. All right, guys. So a moment ago, you just saw me draining the rest of the juice from the Lemo 2. And basically, what I experienced was a diminishing return on vapor production and less flavor until it started giving me the warning that it was a dry hit condition. And but let's take a look. You know, this is the dry tank. I'm going to take it off in a second and take a look at the wick. But let's fire this up, and you can see here what my settings are. So we have the joules, we have the voltage of the battery, we have the resistance of the coil, we have the temperature, and you can see how it's set to powerful. This is a moment after I just was doing that. And here's the tank. So let's do this. It's reading 460 degrees, you can see, and let's fire this. Okay, so it's reading dry. Okay, so I want to taste this real quick while I'm here. So it's producing a tiny bit of vapor. Just a little bit. So it's still heating the coil, but no dry hits even at 460. Wonderful. So there you go. Let's take this off. This is my special TVC edition. eLeaf was nice enough to put my brand on there for my channel, which was really sweet. Anyway, more into the staying on track and remaining focused, let's take this apart. Here is this build deck that I have been killing. And you'll see here that I'm using a twisted build that David from, you know, David D. Jaquith from Everybody's Videos. An awesome, awesome, knowledgeable guy from all of the vape community. He's also on the vape team, which I've said before. I'm just happy to have him. You know, the more assets we have in this community, the better it is for all of us. We all help each other. And this is freaking on here tight. Holy crap. Time to take out the power tools, my friends. Holy crap, that's on there. What is this, super glued? My God, this is tight. Holy shit, shit, shit. Be careful over tightening your tank, guys. I was one step away from getting out the blowtorch and the chainsaw, but I got it. So, all right. Let's zoom down. And this build's been in my other Lemo 2 for about 5 days maybe, so there's gonna be some darkening from the juice. Some gunk built up, but let's not confuse gunk with burnt cotton. And you'll notice that this twisted build and these little black specks that you see here are just the juice cooking on there. Let's grab some fresh organic cotton. And I'm going to pause the video for a second and set this build up. All right, so here's some fresh organic cotton. I'm just going to do a little piece for the purpose of this test. Grab it, pull through. So there we go. Put some juice on here and see what happens when we continue firing with juice on it. I'm gonna pulse this a little bit to suck the juice into the wick. All right, so there's juice on there. And let's go out a little bit. All right, let's fire away. I can already see the dry warning coming up on the screen. I don't smell any burnt cotton whatsoever. All right, so there you go. And let's remove this. And let's see what we have here. There you go. Just a little bit of the residue on here from the coil that I've been using for the past week, but I mean, no burning, no smell of burning. So that's a win. And that was at 460 degrees, guys. So the temperature control obviously works, and I'm completely happy with the results so far. It's been a really thrilling experience to get a good solid tank vape and not have all the resistance issues and the jumping around and the battery, you know, fluctuation issues and all the other stuff that, you know, we have to deal with sometimes. So it's a win so far. Let's switch screens and I'll give you my final words and analysis, initial final words and analysis.
All right, guys. So you saw the up close, you saw all the improvements. I'm really impressed with, you know, the lot of pressure was put on Yihe to deliver with this new chip. The original SX350 chip was stunning, but it had limitations. I think they've improved on everything they set out to improve upon, and Yihe has really taken the lead. I mean, my favorite devices have Yihe chips in them, Sigelli devices, my SX Mini, and now this. It's been a tremendous, tremendous road to growth for them, and I'm really pleased to use their products. Is this an expensive device? Yes. Is it not affordable for a lot of vapers out there? Yes. The good news is that all of this innovation and all this research and development, this chip sets the standard for all the chips that are going to come after it that Yihe will put into more affordable products. Once they nail the main chip, they're going to have less expensive ones. So it's good for all of us. We need to have, you know, top tier devices and then have step down from there. It's like that in every industry and in every field. So when the price comes down, we all win, and that's really good for us. The quality is top-notch, no complaints there whatsoever. I love the feel in the hand. I wish this notch was a little bit bigger like the old one, but hey, it's still there, and it still feels better than most devices. And the trade-off to have the smooth rounded edges, it's a win in that respect also. I no longer get that digging that I used to get from the corners here at the bottom. It did bother me a little bit, not a huge amount. And I do wish on the next revision they do a little bit more with the gravity sensor and the vertical method. And I also hope that they improve upon the battery compartment door with maybe some texture or a spring or a flipping method of getting to the battery easier. You know, that's just my thing. Okay, performance. Let's take this for a vape. So I have this set to 40 joules, which I don't really understand joules too much. So, and also, if you're the kind of person that wants to have the most in-depth, thorough product test, you know, for 2 weeks or 3 weeks or 4 weeks or 6 weeks, that's why YouTube's beautiful. There's tons of different reviewers. There's tons of different review styles. Everyone has different skill sets. Everybody brings something different to the marketplace. I watch 25. You should see my list of my subscriptions. I watch tons of reviewers, and I enjoy them all differently. Some are more entertaining. Some are more educational. Some are more thorough. Some are more, you know, just a general overview. But I like them all for different reasons. This review or preview or whatever you want to call it is really just day one and two, my impressions, comparing it to other temperature controlled devices I have, and does it deliver initially on what my expectations were? And the answer to that question is yes, 100% definitely. If this continues with the performance that I've experienced so far, you know, it's a win. Are there going to be problems that other people come across, that I might come across as time continues? Yes. If you want to make an end-all be-all buy and invest your money and know that you're making a good choice, then wait. Wait 2 months. Wait till every reviewer gets it and everyone figures out every little detail and all the smoke is cleared, and then you can decide if you want to buy it. But I know a lot of you are impulse buyers like me, and you want to run out and get the newest, latest, greatest, but you want that initial thumbs up saying, yeah, I think it's good. That's what I'm giving you. I think it's good. I think it delivers. I think it's worth the investment. But that's the best I can give today. So don't hold me to the fire if you find out something that I didn't know during this. I'm just here to help you guys. That's it. That's the only reason. And that's what I'm here to give you. So let me have a little sip of coffee. All right. So let's take this for a vape. 0.16. Now, in the manual, it talks a lot about all the different settings. Read the manual. It'll help you a lot to figure this out. Watch some more reviews. I have this set right now on powerful mode, 0.16 ohms, 470 degrees Fahrenheit. I go between 460 and 470. My battery's full and at 40 joules. Let's take this Lemo 2 for a vape. Airflow's all the way open, and it's the nickel build that you guys saw in the up close. The thing I've loved about these Yeehee chips is they're so smooth. Even with temperature control, I don't feel like it's fluctuating or pulsing trying to regulate things. I don't feel like it's actively always searching to not burn. It doesn't burn, but it doesn't feel like it's throttling so much like my DNA 40 devices do. My analysis of this device is coming more from a place of just an average vapor that is giving you my vaping impressions, not the technical aspects impressions of what's going on behind the scenes. But that's why there's other vapers that love to dig in like that. So look for that. I'm sure you'll find out a lot. I did hear that people were talking about, you know, this is just a copy of a Jules rebadged version of, you know, the DNA 40 chip. No way. First of all, it's not even a 40 watt chip, it's 60 watts. So that kills the DNA 40 to begin with. Then my vape experience is better. It's purely better. It's just producing an amazingly flavorful, rich vaping experience that is just the right temperature, no fear of dry hits. That's what we all want. I can't wait until the day comes where this type of vape is at a more affordable level that is less complicated in terms of building and nickel and wire and resistance and joules and, you know, flux capacitors and all this crazy technical shit that you need a degree for. I want vaping to be simple and enjoyable for everyone. Vaping is in its true infancy, and as we progress, if we all fight for our right to vape and don't allow the government to control innovation and control the new products being released on the market, hopefully we'll see a day where the standard vape is this type of vape for everybody. And let me tell you something, when that day comes, smoking is dead. Millions of lives will be improved and saved. I'm all for it. I'm an advocate of vaping. 1,000% it's changed my life, and that's why I do this. Yeehee, awesome device. Congratulations to you guys. This is going to be a hot seller. It's on my number one list thus far. If you want to pick it up, it's in stock today at the date of this review. I can't promise tomorrow, so run out and pick it up if you're interested at www.wetvapes.com. thank you for watching the Vapor Chronicles. If you're not a subscriber, subscribe today. I always do my best and I try to give you the most up-to-date information that's current and truthful and honest. You can also find me on the web at www.thevaporchronicles.com and fight for your right to vape. Go to www.casaa.org and join today. Membership is free. No better time than now. Let's keep this ball rolling with innovation and helping people change their lives for the better. Thank you for watching this edition of the Vapor Chronicles, and I will see you very, very soon. Thanks for watching. We'll be right back.